vicious propaganda. Why did people hate Isa? Did Isa alayhi salam do anything wrong that he should be hated for? Did he do any violence? Did he kill people? Did he slaughter people? Did he steal money from people? Why was he hated? There's a question. We have to think about these things. The reason is, it seems like because he was just like the rest of the prophets, a caller for peace and prosperity and success. Anyone who stands up and calls for peace, prosperity and success, immediately they will turn the picture around and say, you are the violent, you are the terrorist, and you are the one who's trying to divide. SubhanAllah. Ajeeb. Therefore nowadays, yeah, even from the coincidental matters, nowadays some people, especially in the media and all these things, they love to call Muslims terrorists or associate terrorism with Islam. SubhanAllah. American Muslims are among the most educated layer in the American society, and American Muslims contribute positively every day to this country and to the well-being of this country and to the prosperity of this country and to the peace process and progress and civilization in this country, SubhanAllah. So either you have to listen from one ear or you have to like negotiate the facts and see what it is. Does Islam really associate itself with terrorism? No. As a matter of fact, it's not a hidden matter to know that Islam was the first one to be a victim of terrorism. Islam denounces terrorism and was victimized by terrorists and radicals and extremists, which happened throughout every single layer of society, anywhere, and any religion, and any background, and any ethnicity, and any political belief. There's always extremists and there's always moderates. That's normal. But there was a problem that these people attacked Isa alayhi salam. And there were many attempts to kill Isa alayhi salam. As you know, we don't, even though we don't believe in that he was, alayhi salam was killed, but for example, Nasara and Yahud, they believe he was killed. By who? And I'm not telling you to go watch that movie, because that's not where we get the seerah from. If you watch it for your own education, that's fine. But some people, they come to the masjid and they have information about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the PBS publication Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. With all the respect, that may be a good work to a certain extent, but that's not where we take the knowledge and the seerah from. We take it from the Quran and the authentic sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Isa alayhi salam was victimized, was tortured, was prosecuted, was even attempted to kill him, and according to them, they also killed him. Finalized him. Why? What did he do? What did he say? He came to tell them, worship Allah, الذي لا إله إلا هو. There is no one but Allah. Worship him. No. He tell us to worship him. What happened to Isa alayhi salam is you have two fractions. Fraction that hated him so much that they persecuted him and they went after him and tortured him and attempted to kill him and called him all kinds of names wrongly and erroneously. And another sect that went so extreme in Isa that they made him God. Or they attributed him with the attributes of Allah in their eyes. Look at these, look how you have extremes. Extreme to say, a man, a prophet of Allah, a caller for peace, a caller for the truth, comes and tells people, worship Allah. People say, you're wrong, you are this. They call him all kinds of names, like they call the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sustained even also more than that. They called him a poet, they called him a magician, they called him a liar, they called him all kinds of things. You know that. That happens, it seems, it happens to everyone who stands and says the truth. They will call you names. So, get ready for that. That's what happened to Isa. The other ones, they said, no, no. You must be Allah. The reason I'm giving you this example of Isa alayhi salam, so you can see, and we have to always look at history, so we benefit from history. History. Many people say, what is the benefit? They're talking about history. These are things of the past. That's it. Let's just cover them and then we go on. We live our own life. How can you understand your presence and plan for your future if you don't know your history?
Because history always repeats itself.
Humans are humans.
The behavior is behavior.
You will always see Abu Jahl. You will always see Abu Lahab. You will always see these people.
And it doesn't mean that you'll see Abu Jahl, Amr ibn Hisham.
No, but you'll see someone who acts like him, is like him, with different name, different face.
And you'll always see the Sahaba al-Kiram.
These things will always happen throughout history. With, of course, different magnitudes and different levels.
Our talk today is a continuation of the past Jum'ah about the fourth Khalifa, Al-Khalifa al-Rashid, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib.
And in order for us to understand Sayyidina Ali's circumstances and personality, you might say, why are you talking about Isa? In order for you to understand Sayyidina Ali, you have to understand what happened to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And there is actually a hadith that is narrated by Al-Bazzar wal-Hakim fi al-Musadra. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells this. Even though في كلام في الحديث لكنه in the meaning it is correct. He tells him يا علي أو علي in you there is a similarity to عيسى بن مريم in a sense that اليهود they hated him so much until they what حتى بهتوا أمة until they called his mother Mary مريم عليه السلام They called her bad names. I'm not going to say it on the minbar. But you know what they called her. How can you have son without man? Huh? You must be this. They went so much in hating him until they cursed him, they persecuted him, they tried to kill him, all these things, and even his mother, who has nothing to do with him, and initially with his message, they also went after her and called her names and all these things until now. You'll see that until now. And then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam tells him, and also, وَالنَّصَارَى What did the Nasara do to Isa? They went so extreme in him until they declared him God. There is a similarity between Ali ibn Abi Talib then and how people acted and reacted towards Ali ibn Abi Talib as the fourth Khalifa and how people reacted to Isa alayhi salam with the two fractions, one made him, declaring him as God, the creator, وَعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ and others declaring him as evil, pure evil, persecuted him, cursed him, and hated him. I will take you one more step, and we don't want to go through all the ahadith, many ahadith, but I felt it would be, I was going to just talk about the fada'il of Sayyidina Ali, like I talked about the fada'il of all the khulafa in the previous month, 2 months actually, 3 months almost now, we're talking about the Khulafa al-Rashidin, almost 3 khutbahs every Khalifa, radiallahu anhum ajma'in. But I figured it is important, it is imperative for us to understand why is there a cloud? Why is there a sensitivity about Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib? Why people shy away from that? There has to be a key to understand why, and that's why I'm devoting this khutbah to tell you, to reflect some on the historical facts and backgrounds so we can understand, it becomes the key to the understanding of the fourth righteous Khalifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Which of course, I will have to tell you now that I've said that we have two groups, we have the third group. The group that is not extreme to this side and not extreme to that side and those people are Ahlus Sunnah. Who view Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib as the fourth righteous Khalifa.